Hello Techies, in our previous tutorials, we have learned different Excel actions while working with Excel automation. And also, we have learned different database actions while working with SQL database. All right, if you observe the Excel automation action, that is read from Excel worksheet, if you observe over here, I'm having the Excel instance and then I'm going to retrieve the values in a such a way, the value of single cell, values from the range of cells, value from selection, and all available values from the worksheet. But if you observe over here, I can retrieve the data from the particular worksheet which are available under Excel worksheet. All right, but what if I am having Excel with multiple sheets and we need to use Excel as a database and we want to extract data from Excel by using SQL queries? All right, let me show you a small example over here for the Excel, that is employee-list.xlsx file. Now this Excel file having two worksheets. There you can see I'm having employee underscore personal underscore details. It is one of the worksheet where you are having employee ID, name and gender. Another one I'm having employee underscore salary underscore details, where I'm having employee ID and state code and joining date of the particular employee. Along with that, what is the annual salary of the particular employee. Now, by using Excel as a database, now I want to retrieve the data by using OLEDB. All right, before that, we'll see what is OLEDB. OLEDB stands for Object Linking and Embedding Database. It is an API designed by Microsoft that allows users to access a variety of data sources in a uniform manner. A OLEDB provider is a software component that enables an OLEDB consumer to interact with the data source. Now, whenever I'm going to use this Excel as a database, in that case, I'm going to use database actions. And then what I will do, I will go ahead and use the SQL queries over there to extract the data from the Excel, that is from the employee details underscore personal, employee underscore personal underscore details, as well as employee underscore salary underscore details. Now, what is the prerequisite to work with database actions along with the Excel as a database? There we required OLEDB provider. Now, to work with Excel as a database, we need to be installed Microsoft Access Database Engine as a prerequisite in our desktop or the laptop or on our computer. Now, if you go for the Windows, and there if you see, I have already installed Microsoft Office with 64-bit. If you observe over here, I am having Microsoft Office, Microsoft Publisher 2010, and there also I have installed my Microsoft Excel related. Now, to use the SQL queries inside my database actions or database queries, in that case, we should install Microsoft Access Database Engine on your desktop. Now, let me go to the control panel. If you see, I'm going to the control panel, that is appwith.cpl, and then I'm going to click on OK. Now, if you see over here, I'm having Microsoft Access Database Engine 2010. So, which has already I have installed this Microsoft Access Database Engine to access my Excel as a database using OLEDB provider. Now, what is this OLEDB connection? An OLEDB connection can store in an Excel workbook. When Excel opens the workbook, it creates a memory or copy of the OLEDB connection known as OLEDB connection object. By using that, we can go ahead and we can retrieve the data from the Excel by using SQL queries. All right. Now, if you see over here, I'm having the connection string in a such a way, provider equal to Microsoft AS.OLEDB.12.0. This what it will represent to connect to the provider, that is OLEDB provider. We are using this provider as OLEDB, that is 12.0 version. It is common for all 2007 to latest version of the Excel. All right. Now, if you see the data source over here, I have given it as d:\training-employee-list.xlsx, which we have just shown you. This is the Excel, the path of the data source. Next one, if you see the extended properties, I'm going to use Excel 12.0 in the XML format. And then if you see HDR equal to yes, what does it mean? The headers we need to retrieve or not. If HDR equal to yes, it indicates that the first row contains the column names. If HDR equal to no, in that case, it indicates the first row does not contain the column names. All right. And along with that, if you see I'm having persist security info, that is the main. If you are going to set persist security info equal to true or false, it won't show much difference for the upfront, but the difference is happening at the back end. What is the difference over there? When persist info equal to false, the security sensitive information such as password is not returned as part of the connection. If the connection is open or has been, even if it is open state. If you are going to set persist security info equal to true, Windows will remember the password specified in the connection string. All right, this is all about the OLEDB.